What's cracking, guys? It's been a minute. Wanted to do a cool little review of this vehicle right here. It's the first time I've actually been in SoCal where I had time to actually kick it with people, right? So I hit up my boy here, Izzystillydgn. Check him out on Instagram, check him out on YouTube. This is his clean ass EG hatch. This guy's got a tons of parts on this thing. I've been wanting to sit down and kind of go over them just to kick it off, bro. How you doing?
Good,
man.
How are you?
I'm good, bro. How's it going? I'm gonna finally kick it down here, dude. Tell us a little bit about your car, man. How long has it been?
Well, I've had my car for 2.5 years now. I got it back in January 4th of 2016. Yeah, this is it. I didn't look anything like this when I first got it. It was definitely a piece of shit. Still is. But now it's, you know, a little bit nicer piece of shit.
No, dude, it looks great, dude. I don't know what you're talking about, dude. Look at these gorgeous fenders you have here, bro. You got the charge speeds.
Yeah, charge speed fenders, buddy club hood, chain racing lip.
Okay, all right.
Wheel woods up front, because AK ones.
Dude, check these out. This guy's got the wheel woods up front, the Cosi K1s.
They're the 16x7.5 model, so they're like, I guess, rare specs.
Yeah, specs for sure.
Not many people have them. A lot of people have tried buying them off of me, but I'm like too attached to them.
I would be at this point too.
Yeah,
dude. Man, I love the duckbill and everything you got going on. Hey, how'd you get this exhaust, dude? Because I know that shit's pretty rare too.
Yeah, this is the Grady Dynamic Tune exhaust. I actually found it on Craigslist.
dude.
Yeah, I found it on Craigslist,
that's,
and then
that's
Prior to this, I had the Apex I World Sport 2,
okay.
And then when I saw that on Craigslist, I posted my World Sport 2 for sale, and once it sold, I went and bought this, and it's for a coupe, so the piping had to get chopped and modified
and
stuff.
Right, I remember that. Yeah, yeah.
It sucked to do it, but I love the way that it sounds.
No, dude, and it looks
I love the way that
too.
It looks, yeah.
You never see that, dude.
Yeah,
see that at all. Yeah, dude, I mean, I've been watching your car's build for a while now on Instagram. I'll put everything down here, guys. Definitely check this guy out. I love the fucking car, dude.
Thanks, dude.
Yeah, dude. Let's take a moment to talk about this guy's swap, actually.
Okay.
I think that's the crown jewel of this entire thing here. All right, guys, so check this out. You don't really see these too often, right? We got an F20B. So for all you guys out there that love to see these, you know, Frankenstein swaps, here's a beautiful specimen. Tell us what you got going on right here. How'd you get this to work?
This is an H2B setup, but instead of an H22, H23, I'm using an F20B long block,
nice.
Which is essentially like an H22. It's just D-stroke, revs out a little bit more. Same amount of power, a little bit less torque. Nonetheless, great setup. But this is an F20B long block.
Okay.
And I have an Integra Type R transmission.
Oh, wow. Okay, you got a Type R swap, or Type R trans, at least.
Type R trans, yeah.
Sick, dude.
That's the 4.7,
you know,
final drive. And then I've got a K-Series RBC intake manifold.
Check this out. You don't see this very often as well. How'd you get that to attach? You have a Skunk2 adapter?
Yeah, I'm using the Skunk2 intake manifold K to H adapter.
Okay, cool.
And yeah, it just bolted right up. And then K-Series manifold. If anybody's going to message me asking me how I would like this over the stock manifold, I don't know because I never ran the stock manifold. So all I know is that this K-Series one looks way better.
Okay. No, it looks way better in the bay. What'd you use for an H2B swap? Like, how did you get it mounted up?
So I'm currently using the PLM H2B Kit.
Okay.
So there's a plate in the middle, and then you get a flywheel spacer.
Right,
and
right.
And then you got to shave the block to fit the half shaft.
Oh, wow.
And then so you can clear axles. Yeah, it's...
Oh, man, it's definitely some effort to get
in
here.
It's...
Check this out over here, too. I saw this when we were over in Fontana. There's barely any clearance right here, guys. Look at this. Did you have to shave this at all?
I dented it so the timing cover can fit.
Right, right.
It'll fit without the timing cover, but I wanted the timing cover on.
Yeah.
It looks a little more complete.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Yeah,
so I wanted the timing cover to be on, so
that's
I just
awesome.
Banged that strut tower in.
And what booster and master cylinder are these? Is this the stock one?
Yeah, that's just stock.
Okay.
I just have a finishing lines brake line tuck kit.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. And that's just it gives you enough for the Willwood for the stocks?
To be honest, I think my booster or my master is leaking. But okay. I have both of them brand new that I'm swapping out.
Okay.
And then I'm flushing the brake fluid, putting better brake fluid in there. And then once I install everything, it should feel a lot better. Because the pedal's still a little bit spongy right now.
Okay, yeah, because I was thinking, you know, you got the Wilwoods. I didn't know how the stock ones would manage. But, I mean, if it's managing now, you're just going to replace them. That's cool.
Yeah, yeah.
That's awesome, yeah, dude.
I got brand new ones waiting at home to be installed.
Okay.
Just, you know, I said I was going to do the steering rack and all that stuff. Rear trailing arm bushings and shit,
right,
like that.
Right.
So I'm just gonna do it all at once the car's on jack stands and I'm
driving. You know, stuff. Once it's not driving, you can just do whatever the hell you want to it, right?
Yeah.
Have you actually gotten this on a dyno yet?
Yeah, yeah. It dyno tuned over at DT Honda Motive, 185 to the wheels.
Oh wow.
And 146 torque all motor. I am running nitrous on the car.
Nitrous, and, you say?
Yeah.
Nitrous.
Yeah. That's, so
there you go.
So it's running. I mean, it's running a small dry shot.
Okay.
And then I've got a separate tune for that. And then I have my all motor tune, nitrous tune. I'm running Hondata S300.
Okay.
So with the flip of a switch, I can run my nitrous map.
That's awesome. What kind of power you put down with the shot?
It should be. Let me see. Should probably be like 230, 240 with the nitrous shot.
Oh wow.
That I'm running.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's some good all motor too.
Yeah, all motor is 185, but this is an automatic long block, so the cams aren't as aggressive as the manual long block would be.
Okay.
So once I get those manual cams in, I should be making over 200 all motor.
All motor.
Plus
that's,
the nitrous, so it should
that's
be.
That's awesome.
Should be fun.
Yeah. Yeah. Did you put your interior back in, or are you
no.
gutted? Yeah. Let's check this out.
I want to put my interior back in, but. I need to find clean interior first.
Definitely, definitely.
I have JDM door panels at home, so
that's
I'm gonna do
awesome.
The power window conversion.
Okay. And you got all checkered sports going on?
Yeah, yeah. Checkered sports driver plate, the dead pedal, the passenger foot plate, and then behind the passenger seat. Oh, it's a mess. I've got the checkered sports cup holder.
Oh, the checkered sports cup holder. There you go. Yeah, I want to get one of those, dude. Those are tight. Those are
cool.
Tight. Yeah, it's really cool. Raul literally is the master of dimples. Just dimples everything. That's cool. And you got the K-tune shifter?
Yeah, K-tune shifter with the checkered sports shift knob as well.
Dang, this guy's...
That's probably one of the best shift knobs in the world.
Yeah.
Like, without a doubt.
Is it the aluminum one or the steel one?
I don't know, but it's fucking heavy.
Okay, so it might be... Yeah, I think it's the stainless one.
It's,
the stainless one's like 120 grams or something like that.
Yeah, it's like
over
the
60
best
maybe.
Shift knob I've ever felt.
Dude.
With. Like,
that's,
I love that shift knob.
That's
down.
Awesome, guys.
Yeah.
But yeah, dude... this is just one of my favorite EGs I know of, and I love it. I'm not gonna lie, guys. This shit's super, super clean. With the Kosi K1s, you don't really see them that often, to be honest with you. And what were the fitment you said?
They're 16x7.5, 43 offset.
Okay,
so they're offset. A little bit harder to find. A
little bit.
The
yeah,
15
yeah, yeah.
inch.
But I really love the Wilwood kit, man. Like.
Oh yeah, me too.
You see those on S2000s, you see them on FDs, and they do an amazing job. And I can't imagine them not stopping this car. I mean, your car probably weighs like what, 2200, 23?
Probably like 23, 24 with me in it.
Okay,
yeah,
okay.
Your boy's heavy.
But I definitely think it's gonna stop it. Guys, this is an amazing car. If you're not checking this dude out, definitely check him out. He does have a YouTube channel, Izzystillydgn. I'll put everything down below, but he's super active on Instagram. I'll put all his information down here. Super active, right? And if you're in SoCal, this man details. So,
hey,
Hit him up, you know, because I mean, literally every day I see this fool waxing his car on the weekends. He's got another ride too that he's constantly working on. So definitely hit this guy up. Let's check this engine bay one more time. I just love the simplicity of it. It's super empty, and it's not shaved or anything like that, you know? It's just really clean, really done well. You got the F20B, ITR, trans here. I still cannot get over the RBC. It looks great. It's a well-collected car, guys. Let's take another quick look here.
It was all done in my front yard, man.
Oh, that's right, huh? Didn't you paint this car yourself?
Yeah, I did the engine bay myself. Everything in here, I did basically myself. The first time around, I had a lot of help from my friend Isaac Garcia.
Okay.
Omar Gonzalez. And Omar helped me out with the engine. Isaac and Omar did like all the engine seals, timing belt, water pump, all that. Mechanical stuff.
Yeah.
They took care of that because they're pros at that. I can't do that for shit. But as far as like doing the engine bay, doing the brake line tuck, doing the fuel line, dropping the motor in, like that. I did it all in my front yard. I painted the engine bay myself. It was the first time I ever painted anything with like automotive paint and a spray gun.
Yeah, dude.
I like the way that it came out.
No, dude, it came out great. Came out great. Well, shit, man. Thanks, man. Thanks for having time. Thanks for kicking it with me. Yeah, we were literally just down here, and I was just like, bro, I got like 10, 15, 20 minutes before I got to head back down to NorCal, because we're in Riverside right now, and I was just like, bro, let's get together. So super glad we got to make that happen, guys. Definitely check out his build, YouTube, Instagram. Definitely check him out. Tell us what you think of this build. Leave it down in the comments below. I can't get over looking at this car, man. So definitely going to get some pans after this. I'll work them in. You guys, you know what I do. And then I'll check you guys later. Peace.